Hi everybody, my name is Oscar Rojas, PhD student at the University of Illinois at the Stein Monogastric Nutrition Laboratory, and today I have the pleasure to talk about energy, phosphorus, and amino acid digestibility in Lemna protein concentrate, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal fed to weanling pigs. This is the outline of my presentation. I will start with a brief introduction where I will explain how Lemna protein concentrate is produced, and then I will move on to the three digestibility experiments, energy, phosphorus, and amino acids, and then I will finish my presentation with some conclusions and the implication of this research. To explain how Lemna protein concentrate is produced, it is important to mention that Lemna plant is also known as a dudweed, and it is a flea-floating aquatic plant that grows rapidly on the surface of water. Lemna has a relatively high concentration of nutrients and contains from 35 to 45% of crude protein, and crude fiber range from 7 to 10%. And commercial production of Lemna takes place mainly in tropical climates. The production of Lemna protein concentrate begins when the Lemna plant is harvested. This process separates the liquid portion out of the pulp portion. When in the process they use the liquid portion, Lemna protein concentrate is produced, and this product can be used as an ingredient in the animal feed field, and it has been tested to be included in human food. On the other hand, the pulp portion can be used either to produce Lemna meal or biocrude. The Lemna meal can be used as an animal feed ingredient, and this ingredient is quite similar to alfalfa meal, and that is why it can be used to feed cattle. And the biocrude is used to produce renewable fuels. Lemna protein concentrate contains approximately 68% of crude protein. This has a relatively high concentration of indispensable amino acids, and it is therefore possible that Lemna protein concentrate can be used as a replacement for traditional protein sources in diets fed to pigs. But at this point, no data on the nutritional value of Lemna protein concentrate fed to pigs are available. And at this point, I would like to mention that this product is produced by a company called Parabel. This table shows the nutritional composition of Lemna protein concentrate, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal. We observe that the Lemna protein concentrate contains 93.9% of dry matter, and in the case of fish meal and soybean meal, is 89.9% and 89.4% respectively. As we can also see here, crude protein concentration in Lemna protein concentrate is 68%, in fish meal 63.2%, and 48% in soybean meal. The concentration of acid hydrolyzed ether extract, phosphorus, and ash is numerically greater in fish meal than in Lemna protein concentrate and soybean meal. And the concentration of gross energy in kilocalories per kilogram in Lemna protein concentrate is 5800, in fish meal is around 4400, and in conventional soybean meal, 4300. The objective of this research was to determine the concentration of DE and ME and calculate the standardized total tract digestibility of phosphorus and the standardized ileal digestibility of crude protein and amino acids in Lemna protein concentrate, and to compare these values with values in fish meal and conventional soybean meal. Let's start with the energy digestibility experiment. For this experiment, we used 32 barrels, with initial barrel weight of 16.8 kg. We had 4 treatments with 8 pigs per treatment, and fecal and urine samples were collected for 5 days after 5 days of the adaptation period. For this experiment, we formulate a corn basal diet, in addition to 3 experimental diets which contain the test ingredient, Lemna protein concentrate, fish meal, and soybean meal, in addition with corn. The data were analyzed by ANOVA using the PROGMIC procedure of SAS, The fixed effect was the diet, and the random effects were the peak and the replication. Let's move on into the results. In this slide, we observe the apparent total tract digestibility of gross energy. In the x-axis, we have from left to right corn, Lemna protein concentrate, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal. And in the y-axis, we have the apparent total tract digestibility in percentage. We observe that the apparent total tract digestibility of gross energy was less in Lemna protein concentrate than in corn, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal, and no difference were observed among corn, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal. Now we are looking at the DE concentration on a dry matter basis. The DE concentration was less in corn than in the other test ingredients, but the DE in fish meal was less than in soybean meal, but no different than in Lemna protein concentrate. However, when we are looking at the ME concentration, also on dry matter basis, we observe that no difference were detected among test ingredients. So the conclusion of this experiment is that the apparent total tract digestibility of gross energy was less in Lemna protein concentrate than in the other ingredients, but the ME was not different from the ME in corn, soybean meal, and fish meal. And the implication of this research is that the concentration of ME will therefore not be changed if Lemna protein concentrate is used in diet fed to pigs. Now let's move on to the second experiment, phosphorus digestibility. In this experiment, we used 24 barrels with initial barrel weight of 12.5 kilograms. We have three treatments with 8 pigs per treatment. And in this experiment, feces were collected for 5 days after 5 days of adaptation period. And data were analyzed as explained for experiment 1. This slide shows the ingredient composition of the experimental diets. As mentioned before, we formulate three experimental diets where each test ingredient was the only source of phosphorus in the diet. We observe in the first row the test ingredient, Lemna protein concentrate, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal, and in the second row we have several ingredients such as cornstarch, sugar, soybean oil, vitamins and minerals, and salt. Now let's move on into the results. In this slide, we can see the standardized total tract digestibility of phosphorus. The orange band represents, from left to right, in the x-axis, Lemna protein concentrate, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal. And in the y-axis, we have the standardized total tract digestibility in percentage. We see here that no difference were observed among ingredients. However, the standardized total tract digestibility of phosphorus has a tendency to be greater in Lemna protein concentrate than in conventional soybean meal. And the reason of this observation could be explained due to the less concentration of phytate in Lemna protein concentrate than in soybean meal. And this indicates that there is a greater concentration of non-phytate bone phosphorus in Lemna protein concentrate. And this means that the more phosphorus is available to be absorbed in this ingredient. And the conclusion of this experiment is that the standardized total tract digestibility of phosphorus had a tendency to be greater in Lemna protein concentrate than in soybean meal. Now, let's move on to the last experiment of today's presentation, amino acid digestibility. In this experiment, we used 8 barrels with initial barrel weight of 21.4 kilograms. 4 diets were formulated. Each period was considered 7 days, and the first 5 days of each period were considered the adaptation period, and ileal samples were collected for 8 hours on days 6 and 7. The design of this experiment was a repeated 4x4 Latin square design with 4 periods and 4 diets. Here we can see the composition of the experimental diets. A nitrogen-free diet was formulated to calculate the basal endogenous losses of crude protein and amino acids. and these values corrected the apparent ileal digestibility of amino acids and crude protein to calculate the standardized ileal digestibility of amino acids and crude protein. In this experiment, we use the difference procedure, and that is why we formulate a soybean meal basal diet in addition to the Lemna protein concentrate and fish meal diets. And that's why you observe that soybean meal was included also in the test ingredients to be able to calculate the amino acids and crude protein digestibility by difference. The data were analyzed by ANOVA using the PROGMIX procedure of SAS. The fixed effect was the diet, and the random effects were the peak and the replication. Now let's move on into the results. Now we are looking at the standardized ileal digestibility of lysine. We have on the x-axis in green Lemna protein concentrate, in orange fish meal, and in blue conventional soybean meal, and in the y-axis we have the standardized ileal digestibility in percentage. The SID of lysine was greater in fish meal than in Lemna protein concentrate, but less than in conventional soybean meal. Now, when we are looking at the SID of methionine, this amino acid follows the same pattern as the SID of lysine. It was greater in soybean meal than the other test ingredients. And the SID of threonine here also followed this pattern of the two previous amino acids. It was less in Lemna protein concentrate than in the other ingredients, but it was less in fish meal than in conventional soybean meal. And the conclusion of this experiment is that there was some difference in the SID of amino acid between fish meal and Lemna protein concentrate, but in average, most of the amino acids were not different between these two ingredients. But the SID of most amino acids was slightly less in Lemna protein concentrate than in conventional soybean meal. So the overall conclusions for these three experiments are that the ME concentration in Lemna protein concentrate was not different from the ME in corn, fish meal, and conventional soybean meal. Also, that the standardized total tract digestibility of phosphorus had a tendency to be greater in Lemna protein concentrate than in soybean meal. The amino acids in Lemna protein concentrate were relatively well digested, but for most amino acids, there were no difference between the amino acids in Lemna protein concentrate and fish meal. And with this, I would like to thank you for your attention, and you are welcome to view and read other information in our website.